My name is Doug Oates, Product Specialist with the Data Access Governance team. And today I'm excited to be able to cover how we can now perform an analysis simplified insight into Microsoft 365 document libraries as well as OneDrive for Business. And that includes both permissions as well as sharing links. So if we look at the new capability that we provide within File Reporter 4.0, we provide the ability to do a security analysis and collect information out of a Microsoft 365 tenant on the Teams and the channels, SharePoint Online sites, as well as OneDrive for Business. So this allows us to provide insight into the security as it relates to document library folders, as well as file permissions, and also the ability to provide insight into internal and external sharing. Now, there are additional capabilities that we provide around data, which allows us to also help you determine what's out there, how it's aging, and duplicate files. But for the purposes of this demo, we're going to be focusing on the permissions within the document libraries, as well as the sharing links. This slide shows the architecture and components of File Reporter on-prem. We have the ability to scan and report on permissions and data within the NTFS file shares. And it also includes our integration with Identity Governance for providing business level access reviews and attestation. Now with File Reporter 4.0, we've added a new agent. It's the Agent 365. And with Agent 365, we can now scan the tenant, and we scan and we collect information on Azure AD users and groups, SharePoint Online, OneDrive for Business, as well as Teams. Now this information, once scanned, is stored in the SQL database so that we can generate reports. This is the File Reporter 4.0 interface, and you'll notice now once you get it installed, there's a new tab for Microsoft 365, and under here go to the agents that are the agent that's installed, and then there's the tenants. So here we can see that I have my tenant here, and that we have scanned this tenant, and we have collected information on the users, the groups, the drive document library drives, the SharePoint sites, Teams, and affiliated channels. And then you can go drill down into this, into the drives. Now, a drive by definition is a top level object representing a user's OneDrive or a document library in SharePoint. And so as you can see, if I drag this up under drive type, here I have my OneDrive for Business that we've collected information on the files and folders within this document library drive for each OneDrive for Business. And then the document libraries themselves that are connected to the sites. We can see that we've collected all the information on each one of the SharePoint sites. Now, some of these document library drives can be affiliated with Teams. Some of them may be affiliated with just SharePoint sites. Once you complete a scan, and maybe you're going in looking at, let's say, I'll just type in finance here, and sort on that, and maybe you found some permissions within the finance document library that needs to be corrected, you can come back and just do another scan of just that particular document library rather than scan the whole tenant. So the next thing I want to do, let me clear that filter out. Next thing I want to do is switch over to Teams itself. And within Teams, we have, when a new team is created, it'll create a general channel, and then you can create additional channels. So if we go out, click here, and go into files, this is where the files are being stored. I'm going to open this in SharePoint. So for every team, there is a back-end SharePoint document library to contain the files. Now the document library drive, if I click over here, is documents. So this is a document library drive. So if I slide this over, this was an existing site that I converted to a team. And so you can see here that I have my general folder here I created a channel called Customers, and a folder got created in the document library. There's an enablement, but also you can go in and create additional folders if you're just using SharePoint. So that's another possibility, and you could have different permissions set up. There's also the option to create additional document library drives, which purchase orders is one here that has some additional folders in there. And depending on how you convert your SharePoint library, it may or may not be connected into a team channel. So we need to be able to scan and look at all of the document libraries and folders where permissions might be assigned. So if I go back to this one here and go to General, we're going to look at Access. You'll notice that there's a sales owners, two sales owners here, sales members, and then Patty has direct access, and I have a sharing link. So all of these are access. Now, the thing that may be confusing is there's two owners here, two sales owners groups. Well, this ties back to one of them being a SharePoint group, and then the other one, if I look at sales right here, this is a group that's connected to the team. So it's both a SharePoint group, and it's a Teams group gets created, which is the Microsoft 365 group. These get linked together. Now, if we go back and look at these groups, we also have a security group that can be assigned permissions and a document library drive and folders within that. So we have to be able to collect all this information, including sharing link permissions, in order to do a thorough assessment of access into these document libraries. So with all this in mind, the next thing I want to do is switch back over to File Reporter. And let's go in and look at some of the reports. So we'll type in, go into report definitions here. Okay, and now I've filtered based on Microsoft 365 reports. So I could go in and I can look at this in multiple ways here. We have if I go in into one that's based on sites, I've created a report here. And in this report, I can see the summary here for the detail, the summary of all of these different sites. Some of them are team sites. Here's a product group that's just a SharePoint site with a document library drive in it. So if I look at the summary of this, we can see the number of direct permissions that are assigned within the document library and folders, as well as files, as well as sharing links. So we have 13%, 23 sharing links that are set up against these particular document libraries. And then we can look at the distribution by access type. How much of those are read access versus write versus owner access, which is full control. And then I can begin to go into the details. So if we look into the sales, we can see this is a sales team, and it has two document library drives. One is documents here, which has a customers folder, and I can see that an auditors group has access. This is a security group. Compliance members has access, along with the sales members and sales owners. And then if I browse on down, now I can see that here is some direct access to Doug Utz here. Megan Brown has access into the enablement folder, and there's been two sharing links created. There's one is an organizational sharing link, which provides anonymous access based on an organization, and then there's an external user, Frank Connor, that this has been shared with as well. And then if I come on down into the purchase orders, I can see additional information on who has access to the purchase orders document library drive. You can also go back and generate it just based on an individual site. So if I wanted to do an analysis of each one, then this would show the sharing links just as it relates to the sales team here, without bringing in all the other ones as a consolidated view around the distribution. Right, so let's switch back. Now, another thing is sharing out of OneDrive. So this report here, sharing links by user OneDrive, if I click on it, This is going to go out and look at each individual user's OneDrives in the tenant and then generate a report. Now, the challenge with this within the normal Microsoft 365 tool set is you can generate this on a single user that you're logged in as, but as an administrator, you have to be granted access in order to go and look at each one of these on a one-by-one basis. So this allows us to get a consolidated view through the collection that we've done of all the users that have external sharing links or internal sharing links created. For example, if I look at Doug here, I can see that he's created a sharing link out to and shared out this Augusta National Club wallpaper to these users, but he's also shared a resume doc out with Frank Connor, who's an external user. Now, the other thing that I like to show, I'm going to switch over to, and we're going to take a look at the report here. So any of these reports can be saved out into a CSV file and then brought into Excel where you can further filter on it. So let's look at the one for the department site permissions details. So if I bring this up into Excel, it opens up some additional thing that I can do. For example, maybe I want to just look at and filter just on sharing links. So now I can see the sharing links here for each one of these and which one, what's been shared out. And then I can see who the trustees are right here. This was one that's shared out to an email address. Here's organizational. And then it gives the scope of the sharing link, and then whether you can download it, is there a password assigned, and is it associated with the entity that's associated with, was it with a team, engineering team, or in this case, I have a product group that's just a SharePoint site. This allows you to get more in-depth, so I can go back and change this filter right here, or I may just want to look at, you know, things as it relates to, you know, files here and what permissions are assigned directly to files. And then I could go in and I could do a sort based on sharing link right here. And then I can see all the direct assignments and then all the sharing links to just individual files. And I can do the same thing for folders. So this allows us to just get more in-depth into it, and especially if you're working off of this as a project and wanting to make corrections to the permissions. So as we go back, you know, in summary, with File Reporter 4.0, we have the ability now to go in and collect the information and show the permissions to the OneDrives for business and the sharing links that I just showed you, as well as generate reports on all the sites that are affiliated with SharePoint and Teams, and be able to generate a report showing all the permissions that are assigned both direct to a user through one of the different types of groups, security, Microsoft 365, and SharePoint, and also sharing link permissions. So thank you very much, and I hope you have a great day.